This is a polar planimeter, probably from the 1960s. Actually, it's a THS Charvaz compensating polar planimeter with zero set device. With the original case. It's got two arms. The weighted arm that stays put, and the tracing arm with the roller on the bottom that moves around. This is the tracing lens, which has a little bullseye. You trace around the edge of a shape, and the dial tells you the area. A planimeter measures the area of a shape just by going around its perimeter. When I first heard about this device, I thought it couldn't be possible. See, two shapes with the same perimeter can have very different areas. Like, this circle and this long rectangle have the same perimeter, but the circle's area is much bigger. So how could anything measure the area just by measuring around the perimeter? Well, the planimeter isn't just measuring the distance around the perimeter. It also takes into account the way the angle here changes as you go around. That extra piece of information makes all the difference. It's pretty amazing you can actually make a device that does this. The nuts and bolts of it is really simple. This wheel just rolls when you move the measuring arm, and that same rolling wheel tells you the answer. No fancy gears, no nothing. The angle is accounted for because the wheel is set away from the pivot, so changing the angle will move the wheel. Here's how you use it. First, you gotta set it upright. This thing has a weight on the end that's not supposed to move. It's got a little spike on the bottom to help it stay put, and you can help even more by putting it on something like this flat rubber piggy I got. Then this peg sits in the little hole on the measuring arm. Now get yourself something you want to measure and choose a starting point. Before you start going around, get yourself in position and hit this button to reset the dial to zero. A lot of planimeters don't have a zero button, so this is a bit of a deluxe feature for this model. Now you trace around the figure going clockwise, and once you've gone all the way around, the answer shows down here. This planimeter reads in square inches, and you read the answer by lining up the zero on the left with the dial on the right. So this would be 0 square inches. And this would be 2 square inches. This here would be 0.7. The round flat dial on the right is for tens of inches, so this reading would be 34.3 square inches. The big 3 over there means 30, and then you got 4.3 on the measuring wheel. Let's do a little check to see if it's working right. Here's a rectangle that I drew measuring 2 inches by 4 inches, so when I measure the area, I should get 8 square inches. Looks like I got about 7.7, which is pretty good, I guess. Now let's do that same rectangle again, but I'm going to add on this thin little tail over here. This will actually change the perimeter by a lot, but the area should only increase a little, so it should still be something around 8. Yeah, that's pretty good. There's another scale on the left of the wheel that goes from 0 to 10, but if you look carefully, you see it doesn't line up with the scale on the right. See, when you line up the zeros, the 10 on the left isn't aligned with the 1 on the right. This is called a Vernier scale, and it's used for reading one more digit with good precision. You see this thing on old calipers, too. I don't want to get into the details, but this measurement here, if you look at the wheel, looks like 4.37. That's because the 7th mark on the left side is lined up with one of the marks on the right. This lets you measure with a lot of precision, but it's a bit silly for this device. I mean, your hand is going to jiggle around quite a bit while you're tracing, and we've already seen it's not terribly accurate anyway. So there's always going to be some error due to slipping and friction in the wheels as this thing is rolling around. The extra precision in this scale will always be far below the margin of error in your measurements. I won't try to explain exactly why this thing works, but in case you're wondering, there's a thing from multivariable calculus called Green's Theorem. Looks like this. This says that measuring some function around the edge of some region is the same as measuring some other function across the inside of that region. In this equation, if you choose the L and the M correctly, you can make the right side equal the area, and then the left side will be some measurement of something around the perimeter. And the wheel and the arms of this planimeter are arranged specifically to measure that other thing on the left side, which is equal to the area. Here's a fun fact. First planimeter was invented by the German mathematician Johann Martin Hermann in 1814. That's before Green's theorem was proved in 1828. So people built the planimeter even before the mathematics behind it was actually developed. Actually, this is typical for most mathematics before the 20th century. See, mathematics is all about thinking deep thoughts and refining and polishing your ideas until they shine like the stars. But in the real world, folks just want to get things done. Sometimes that happens before the theoretical ideas are fully crystallized. So if you want to feel the rhythms of the cosmos and think the thoughts of God in the true language of reality, then learn you some mathematics. But if you just need to know right away the area of the head of Strawberry Shortcake's pet dog, Pupcake, get yourself a planimeter.